Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and I'm going to show you how I make spruce pitch gum. Come along with me. Okay, we're looking for spruce trees that have pitch on the outside of them. Here's a good one right here. And we're just going to go along and collect this pitch and fill up our can. Now, a lot of times you'll find kind of reddish pitch. We're not going to collect that. We'll just collect this yellowish type. It's a fresher pitch with less off taste. Here's a tree with pitch all over it. This is a lucky find. You can see some of this pitch, like here it's older pitch, here, we don't want that. We only want the fresher stuff. Okay. I got the can pretty full here, and I'm starting to spill now, so it's about as full as I can get it. Let's go back to my place and I'll show you how we process it, how we purify it, process it, turn it into bite-sized gum pieces. Okay, I brought it home and we're going to spread it out here and let it dry because there got some snow in it off going through the trees. So we'll let it dry and we'll come back. Okay, now that it's dry, what I'm going to do is go through and pick out the little bits of bark and twigs and maybe some lichens in here. You don't have to get it real clean, just get the bulk of it. Alright, I've got it sorted out pretty good now, cleaned up pretty good. So the rest of it, I'll show you what we're going to do with it. Now, we're going to put it all back in this can here, and then I've got a stainless steel sink strainer. Okay, so we're going to put that inside of a larger can. We're going to fill this can up. This is the can we collected it in. We're going to fill it back up with the pitch, and then we're going to set this over the top of the can and we're going to put it in the oven and strain it out. Okay, now we'll set the oven at 300 degrees. That's 300 Fahrenheit. Okay, now we're ready to put our cans in here in the oven. And we'll check on them a little bit and see how they're doing. Okay, it's been about an hour and 10 minutes. Let's check it. I checked it about 15 minutes ago, and the can was all drained, but there was still a little bit left in the strainer that hadn't dripped on through. Now, okay, the cans here, you want to make sure that they don't have any linings in them, if the cans that you're going to use in the oven, because you don't want any of that plastic or that liner to taint the pitch. Also notice that we have a pan underneath. We don't, you know, if any pitch was to drip off of here, you know, the pitch is very flammable. So we don't want that to catch on fire. We don't want it to drip down and catch on fire. So let's take a look, see how we're doing here. Okay, that looks pretty good. So we went about 45 minutes or so, and that wasn't really long enough. The can had drained, but there was still pitch in here. So about an hour and 10 minutes, it's pretty good. If we left it another 10 minutes, it would drain a little bit more, but that's good enough. Now what we need to do is turn off the oven and let this cool down a bit. All right, what we have here is a aluminum ice cube tray that we've lined with aluminum foil. That's to assist us to get the pitch out once it hardens up. Now, you really don't need this. You can just fashion a trough out of just, you know, freehand fashion a trough out of the aluminum foil itself. But this is real handy to shape it, so we're going to use it. Now, this cooled down enough that we can handle the can, but this pitch is still very liquid, and it's you'll want to do this while it's still very liquid for obvious reasons, so that you can pour this. All right, this is cooled down now to where it's hard enough, cool enough that it doesn't show any fingerprints. So let's go to the next step. We're going to try to get this off of here now. Okay, it's not wanting to come off very well, so let's let it set for a little bit longer. Okay, we're going to try it again. A little section here that just doesn't want to come off. We'll leave this go a little bit longer. Okay, I just took this outside for a little bit here in Alaska winter and cooled it down, and it looks like it's going to pull off now. So, we're ready to go to the next step. So now all that's left is just to break it up into bite-sized pieces. right, we've got it all broke up into bite-sized pieces. Now, the next step is we're going to put it in this Ziploc bag. Now that we've got all in here, we're going to use some cornstarch. And put maybe a tablespoon in here to start with, and we'll see how that goes. Then we need to coat each and every piece all the way around it. And this is, the purpose of this is to keep these pieces from sticking to each other. Okay, it looks like that rounded soup spoon sized spoon is, it will be plenty of cornstarch. Okay, now that it's thoroughly coated, we're gonna sift the cornstarch, excess cornstarch off of it. Okay, after you get done sifting the pitch and the cornstarch and getting all the excess cornstarch off of it, lay it out, spread it out, and let it dry for at least a day. Help it to cure. That'll firm it up when you're chewing on it. Okay, while that's drying, this is the screen that we used. Notice it's all clean. That's one of the good things about using this system is I just took this outside here in Alaska. It's during the winter, and I let it get cold. Other places or different seasons, you can put it in the freezer, get it cold, and then just bang on it and bang on it all over with a hard object, and it'll knock off all the stuff. Okay, now that the pitch is cured for a day at least, you're ready to put it away in the container that you're going to use. Now, I like to store it in a rather low container because you put it in too high of a container and the depth, the weight of the pitch tends to make the lower ones stick together. So now when you chew it, it's not like regular gum where you can just hold it in your teeth, just hold it in your mouth. You have to keep actively chewing this, pretty active, because if you stop and hold it in your teeth, it'll tend to kind of get to stick into your teeth. So you keep on chewing it. Now, this was the traditional gum. It started out, gum was made out of black spruce was the choice, the choice of spruce pitch to use. And they probably made it in a very similar fashion as this. Now, it's also good medicinally. It's very antiseptic, spruce pitch is. So it'll probably help to clean your mouth, clean the bacteria in your mouth. And it should be good for sore throats as well because of its antiseptic abilities. Well, I thank you for joining me. And you guys take care, and we'll see you on the next video.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.